we will be looking at how to use the lab's fast remesh SOP, a tool which performs a remeshing operation on partitioned pieces of input geometry in parallel. The mesh partitions are easily visualized with a toggle. And here we see the difference between partitioning by connectivity versus connectivity and UV islands. We can also partition by a set bucket size of clustered polygons, or a combination of all these options. It is also possible to specify your own partitions with a primitive attribute, such as this painted integer mask. Enabling the option with UV connectivity ensures that UV seams remain intact through the remeshing process. There are a number of different remeshing target types. Target edge length will aim to set the edge lengths of the output mesh to the specified length, respective of unit length. Target output poly count will aim for the specified poly count for the final output poly count. This is a goal and not an exact count, but increasing the number of remesh iterations will more closely match the target at a slight increase of calculation time. The ratio of average input edge length calculates the average edge length of the input mesh and sets the target edge length to a multiplier of this length. Ratio of input poly count will aim for the output poly count to be a multiplier of the input. For example, a poly count ratio of 5 will result in an output with about 5 times the number of polygons as the original. Adaptive remeshing will retain more detail in areas of higher curvature and less detail in flatter areas. The min and max edge length targets limit how short and how long the edge lengths can be. Gradation is a value of 0 to 1 and is the rate at that the edge lengths can change from one triangle to the next.